Sometimes when we do some mindless knitting, like working in stockinette stitch, for example, we relax so much that it affects our tension. That's when we start seeing those gaps that happen every two rows. And not really a big deal, just a minor imperfection. But if you want to have them fixed, keep watching and I'll show you two ways to do just that. By gaps, I mean these spaces that happen every two stitches, and they are obviously bigger. You can see it especially well if you pull this watch and you see that this space is bigger than that one. So these bigger spaces, the gaps, they happen every two rows. Why? Because one of the rows, either knit row or a purl row, is looser. Normally we tend to make a purl row looser, but it might not be the case for you personally, because every one of us has a different knitting style. So you need to determine which of the rows is looser in your case. To do that, take two yarns, same yarn in the two colors, and make a swatch on about 20 stitches when you change the color every two rows. So cast on 20 stitches, or about that, this one has 16. Then work two rows in one color, attach the other one, make two rows in the other one, and then change colors every two rows, and knit the first row and purl the next row. Then you will get a swatch that looks about like mine. It would be stripy, a little fella that is quite bright and nice looking. But we are not gonna just look at it, we're gonna analyze it. And to do that, turn your work, turn the swatch, and look at the wrong side row. What are we looking for? You can see the gaps, right? They're right here. But before we look at the gaps, let's find the ridges that are in solid color. So some of the ridges are multicolored, they happened in the row where we switched colors, and some of them are in solid color. So I'm looking at my olive ridge over here and the orange ridge over here and the olive one again. And once you find those solid color ridges, that's when you look at the gap. So here's the thing. If the gap happens on top of the solid colored ridge, that means that your purl row is looser than your knit row. If the gap happens at the bottom of the solid color ridge, that means that your knit row is looser than the purl row. In my case, in this swatch, the purl row is looser. So you can obviously see that these stitches are bigger than these ones. And the gap happens on the top above the solid colored ridge. So with that information, we know what to fix. We know that, let's say for in this case, we need to make the purl row tighter and the knit row looser. And there are two ways to do that. The obvious solution is to adjust the tension of the yarn. So how do we do that? If you hold the yarn in your right hand, then when you knit the tight row, don't add any tension at all. So that's true for both hands. So if you work in your, if you hold yarn in your right hand, then you would simply just knit a stitch, because I know this, the knit stitches are tight in my case, so I'm not applying any more tension to the yarn. See, the yarn is loose, I'm just holding it, right? If you hold yarn in your left hand, then you do the same thing. You hold yarn in your left hand, you don't do any wrapping whatsoever, just place it on your index finger and then knit this row without adding any tension to the yarn. That's it. I finished my knit row. I know my knit row is tight, so when I was working on it, I didn't add any tension to the yarn. I'm just repeating that to make it clear, okay? Now I turn my work and I know that my purls are usually loose. So if you hold yarn in your right hand, then You wrap the yarn around your little finger like this, and then you start purling. And this time the yarn would be under tension because you wrapped it around your little finger, right? So the yarn that comes out of your hand will not be as loose as it was when you were knitting stitches. In my case, knits are tighter, so that's how we compensate, so to say, for the tension. If you hold yarn in your left hand, then you do the same thing, but in your left hand, you just wrap the yarn around the little finger, and again, you apply additional tension to the yarn. Now it's not as loose, and that kind of compensates. So when I finish this row, you will see the difference. Okay, here we go, the last stitch. And now when I look at the work, see, there are no gaps. These two rows have perfect tension, so it's basically a really good way to fix this issue. But what if you don't want even to think about wrapping yarn or unwrapping it, changing it every row, and you know, remembering to do that? You don't want to think about that, right? There is another way to do it without any additional thinking about changing something every row. So what I suggest you do, you simply change the size of the needle. So let's say, so you take a needle that is one or even two sizes smaller. See the difference? So this one is two sizes smaller than the other one. And if your gap is not big, then one size smaller needle will be perfect. If it is quite a big difference, then try and use a needle that is two sizes smaller. And here's what we do. I came to my knit row and I know that my knit row is tight, right? So I'm not gonna change needles now because I don't want to make it even tighter. So I use the same needle that I used to work before. So that's the size that is regular size for this project, let's say. And I work my knit row with that needle, with the one that is the regular size that I picked for this project. Okay, here's my knit row. Now I move to the purl row. I know this row is loose for me, so my purls are looser. That's when I get a different needle. That's when I get a smaller needle, and I work this row with the smaller needle. And in this case, you don't have to worry about the tension that you apply. See, I have it wrapped, and I had the same thing for the knitting because that's just my habit. If you don't have that habit, that's fine. Just hold the yarn as you would normally hold it without changing the grip of the yarn, without adding any tension or removing the tension in the yarn, because the needle, the smaller size of the needle, it does the job for you. It fixes that issue with tension that is happening because one of the rows is looser. And see, I work my loose row on a smaller needle, and that also fixes the gaps. The good thing about these gaps is that, well, if there is a good thing, right, is that they only happen when you work back and forth, because there are two rows involved, the knit row and the purl row. There is no problem like that when you work in the round and work in stockinette stitch and knit every round, because you are just knitting and the tension is the same for all knits, right? So the biggest issue that you're gonna see with these gaps is gonna be in stockinette stitch that is worked back and forth. Again, not a big deal, not really a problem, not something bad or, you know, something ruining your project. But if you want to fix these little guys, then now you know two ways how to do it. And that's it. Perfect tension and no gaps. Thank you for watching this video and have a wonderful week. I'll see you next Thursday.